In this video, we're going to figure out the ions that make up ionic compound. This is especially useful when trying to write the net ionic equation. We'll practice using 5 examples, starting with the easier one, and then we'll work our way to harder ones. Before we get started, let's briefly go through how ionic compound is formed from its cation and anion, using the crossover method. One tip to remember is that we always write the metal first, followed by the non-metal. In other words, the cation will always be on the left, and the anion will always be on the right. This is very important to keep in mind. In this example, we have Na plus as the cation, S2 minus as the anion. When there's no number in front of the charge like Na plus, that actually means it's a 1 plus. The crossover method is very simple. You take the number in front of the charge and you cross it over to the other atom like this. 1 will cross over to S and 2 will cross over to Na. That will give us Na2S1. Now, since we don't write out the 1, the formula will just be Na2S. Now that we know how to use the crossover method, let's try to figure out the ions that are present in BaBr2. This compound is soluble in water, therefore it will break into cation and anion. In fact, all the 5 examples we're going to look at, they are all soluble in water. So first, our BaBr2, that means it's actually Ba1, Br2. So we know that cation is Ba+, and anion is Br-. At this point, we haven't confirmed the charge yet, we just know that it's Ba is the cation and Br is the anion. So we're going to use the crossover method. 1 from Ba will cross over to Br. Since it's 1, we don't have to write it out. So our anion is going to be Br-. The 2 from bromine will cross over to Ba and that will give us the charge. Our cation is now Ba2+. We should always double check the charge, at least for the cation. You'll see why when we go through our final example. So just bear with me. So for this example, we know we have Ba. Ba is from group 2. So that means group 2 metal will form a plus 2 charge. And looks like we got it right. Now we move on to our second example, which is AlF3. We know that we actually have 1 Al, and the cation is going to be Al with some positive charge, and the anion is going to be F-. So we'll figure out the actual charge next, and we're going to use crossover method for it. So 1 from Al will cross over to F, so that means our anion is F-. The 3 from F will cross over to Al, so that means the charge for our cation is actually Al3+. Now that makes sense because Al is in a group 3 main group, so therefore it will form a plus 3 ion. These two examples that we've worked with all consist of monoatomic ions, meaning ions containing only one atom. We're going to try working with ionic compounds containing polyatomic ion, like this. We have Na3PO4. Na is the metal, which means it will become Na plus cation. PO4, that's the polyatomic part. It's written as a group, so that means we actually have one group of PO4. Our anion is going to be PO4 with some negative charge. We're going to figure it out. So let's confirm the charge. We cross over. 3 from Na will cross over to PO4, so that means we actually have PO4 3- for the anion. And the 1 from PO4 will cross over to Na, and that means our cation is actually Na+. To double confirm, Na is from group 1, main group, and group 1 will form plus 1 ion. So that means we're good to go. So let's try another example. What do you think are the ions that are present in NH4-2CO3? From this example, it looks like we have 2 polyatomic ions that are present. Notice that the NH4 is in a bracket with that 2 outside. Well, that means we actually have 2 groups of NH4. And then we have another group which is CO3. And we actually have only one group of that because there's no bracket. So we use the crossover method. We take the 2 crossover and that will give us CO3 2-. And we take the 1 crossover and that will give us NH4+. So our cation is going to be ammonium ion, which is NH4+. And our anion is going to be the carbonate ions, which is CO3 2-. Let's move on to our final example, CaSO4. And it looks like we have 1 Ca and 1 group of SO4. So we use the crossover method and we get Ca plus and SO4 minus. Now, is this the final answer? Well, let's double check. Remember that we always refer back to the periodic table. So let's look at the periodic table and find where Ca is. So Ca happens to be in group 2. So group 2 methyl, they're going to form plus 2 ion. So that means the charge for Ca is actually a 2 plus. So that means our SO4 is actually 2 minus charge. The 2s got dropped off when they cross over because they get simplified. So that is why it's very important to do the final check to make sure that the charges on the ions are all correct. Here are some compounds for practice in case you're looking for them. I'll place the answers in the description box. Hope the 5 examples help build your confidence in finding the ions in ionic compound. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.